Hi, this is Linda and Aaron with Traveling Flamingo, and today we're going to be going to Polynesia, where we'll be reviewing the Spirit of Aloha dinner show. It is located in the Polynesian at Walt Disney World. We're going to go over the food, what you can expect, the service, the cost, so stay tuned.
So this is a Polynesian-inspired dinner show that includes hula dancing, fire dancing, and it includes all the various Polynesian countries. You can expect to have a nice open dinner show. The roof of the theater is open, so if there is rain or inclement weather, they could cancel the show, so just be prepared for that.
Actually, one of the first times I went with my family, it was raining and they didn't cancel the show, but it's definitely something you'll want to check. And thunder and lightning, I imagine they probably would cancel the show. So when you arrive, you'll go to the main building of the Polynesian Resort, and in there will be a table or booth set up where you check in, and they will give you a lay there. They'll tell you where to wait, and when it gets closer to the seating time, they will take you out. There are two show times, 5:15 and 8:15, and they do want you to arrive an hour early. So if you see the 8:15, depending on the time of the year, you might miss the fireworks, so you're going to want to keep that in mind which show you choose to do, and if you've got young kids with you.
So you can expect family-style dining here, which means they will bring out large platters of food for the whole table, and should you feel like more, feel free to ask. They'll bring out more food for you.
It is described as a tropical feast. When you arrive, they already have the appetizers out for you, which is mixed greens with a ginger lime dressing, soba noodle salad, and fresh pineapple with pineapple coconut buns. It was absolutely delicious. We kept asking for more. The noodles were definitely my favorite. And even when we got our main course out, we still asked for a little bit more fresh pineapple and fresh soba noodles.
So for your main course, you'll have roasted chicken, Aloha pulled pork, Polynesian ribs, and a vegetable medley. This was really good. You know, we found that the appetizers were a lot better. The noodles specifically, Linda really enjoyed. The roast chicken, Aloha pulled pork, and the ribs were, you know, all really good. But again, we found the appetizers a little bit better. You know, I'm sure there's a lot of people who really enjoy these two.
They do have a kids menu that includes mini corn dogs, tater tots, pizza, grilled chicken, or fish. So there's a good variety for any picky eater.
Drinks are also all you care to enjoy when it comes to soft drinks, lemonades, coffees, and non-alcoholic drinks. If you're over the age of 21, however, they do have all you care to enjoy for the Yingling Lager and Bud Light, the Beso del Sol Sangria, and there is a choice of a Chardonnay or a Merlot. So, you know, for adults, they do have alcoholic drinks that are all you care to enjoy, but it's not the whole menu. If you want, like, the pineapple, the fancy pineapple drinks, those are additional costs. Speaking of price, the way in which they price out your meal here is based on proximity to the stage. So there's three categories, and those three categories have different costs. Category one, for those who are 10 and older, is $79 US. Ages 3 to 9 is $46, and that is not eligible for your Disney dining plans. However, categories 2 and 3 are. Category 2 is $74 for adults and $44 for ages 3 to 9. And category 3 is $66 for adults and $39 for those who are 3 to 9. And again, Disney Dining Plan is allowed for those last two categories. However, you can't sit there in front of the main floor on the Disney Dining Plan.
We have sat in both the front and the back areas and have enjoyed our experiences both times. The service is great. They're really attentive. If you need anything, make sure, just ask your server. They'll get you whatever you're looking for. We had a great time with the entertainment. They keep you really engaged. There's a couple times they call up people from the audience, which is always really fun and hilarious as well. Overall, every single time we've gone, we've had a really great time, and we know that the food and the service is going to be wonderful. So if it's not something you've ever tried before, we would highly recommend trying it. It's something different that we don't always get to experience in our hometown as well.
Yeah, it's definitely a very unique and very fun dining event. Disney only really has two theater dining events, and that's Hoop-dee-doo Musical Review and this one. Both of them haven't really changed too much over the years. However, they're great. They're always fun to go to. Kids love them. Adults love them. The food's really good. And you get an awesome show from it. And this really sort of goes to the Polynesian theming of the Polynesian Resort. And definitely a, you know, must see, must go to type of dinner presentation. And, you know, it's very unique, very fun, and you'll always enjoy it. However, the monorails do get really busy after this. So if you are at the Polynesian or just so happen to be around there when this show lets out, you're probably going to have a pretty long line up there at the monorail. So be warned.
We will leave you off with a little bit of the show to enjoy. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch our video. We really hope that you enjoyed it. If you have any comments, questions, suggestions, please do leave them in the comments box below. We will be commenting back. And make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. Thanks very much.